I am Fatma Ahmed Zahi, working as lecturer botany at Government Girls Degree College, Quarry Road, Quetta. The course which I am teaching in this semester is diversity of plants. The topic which I am going to discuss today is fungi. Now, what is mycology? The study of fungi is called mycology. The scientists concerned with the study of fungi are called mycologists. They are heterotrophic telophytes. Now, what are heterotrophs? They are living organisms which cannot manufacture their own food. They may be saprophytic, living on dead organic matter, and parasitic, dependent on a living host. Now, we will discuss the structure of fungi. Fungi are made up of thread-like structures called hyphae. The hyphae may be septate hyphae or sinusitic hyphae. The septate hyphae have cross walls or septum, which the sinusitic hyphae lack. Here you can see the structure of a mushroom made up of thread-like structures called hyphae, which form a network called mycelium. The network of hyphae are present within spore-producing structures or fruiting bodies. Here you can see the structure of hyphae under electron microscope. Now, the classification of kingdom fungi. Kingdom fungi is divided into two divisions, which are Myxomycota and Eumycota. Division Myxomycota is divided into two classes, which are Myxomycetes and Plasmodiophoromycetes. Division Eumycota has the following subdivisions, which are subdivision Mystigomycotina. The important class of subdivision Mystigomycotina is Oomycetes. Subdivision Zygomycotina. The important class of subdivision Zygomycotina is class Zygomycetes. Subdivision Ascomycotina. The important class of subdivision Ascomycotina is Ascomycetes. Subdivision Basidiomycotina. The important class of subdivision Basidiomycotina is class Basidiomycetes. Subdivision Deuteromycotina. The important class of subdivision Deuteromycotina is class Deuteromycetes. Examples: Myxomycetes are also called slime molds. Here I will discuss the life cycle of a myxomycete. Here you can see is a young plasmodium or feeding plasmodium. It becomes a mature plasmodium, which give rise to globular structures called sporangia, singular called sporangium. This is a young sporangium, which becomes a mature sporangium, inside which spores are produced. When the mature sporangium ruptures, the spores are liberated. The germinating spores may form amoeboid cells or flagellated cells, also called swarm cells. When two amoeboid cells fuse, or when two swarm cells or flagellated cells fuse, the process is called syngamy. As a result, a diploid zygote is formed, which again forms a young plasmodium, which develops into a mature plasmodium. Now, the life cycle of Plasmodiophoromycetes, in which I will discuss the life cycle of Plasmodiophora brassica, because they attack the plants of family Brassicaceae. Zoospores infect root hair cells of the plants of family Brassicaceae. Plasmodium is formed in the cells of the root cells or the root hair cells. Club roots of infected Brassica. Here you can see the clubbed roots of infected Brassica. Club roots disintegrate. Root cells break down, thus releasing the resting spores. The resting spores, after getting released, germinate and form zoospore, which again infects the root hair cells of a healthy plant of family Brassicaceae, and the life cycle continues. Now I will discuss the life cycle of a water mold which belongs to the class Oomycetes. In asexual reproduction, the hyphae give rise to globular structures called zoosporangia. Inside each zoosporangium, zoospores are produced, which become encysted, and the encysted zoospore give rise to a germ tube, which again forms the hyphae. In sexual reproduction, male and female reproductive organs are produced. The female reproductive organ is called oogonium, inside which egg nucleus is produced. The male reproductive organ is called enthridium, inside which sperm nucleus is produced. When the egg nucleus fuses with the sperm nucleus during the process of fertilization, diploid zygote is produced, which germinates and forms again the hyphae of the water molds. Now I will discuss the life cycle of zygomycetes. Two hyphae of opposite strains undergo plasmogamy, and after plasmogamy, the tips of the two hyphae come in contact with each other, and they fuse and undergo karyogamy. After which a diploid zygote is produced. The diploid zygote develops into a zygospore, which forms a germ sporangium. After maturation, the germ sporangium ruptures, and the meiospores produced inside the germ sporangium are released, which again forms hyphae of the members of zygomycetes. Here I want to discuss one point. That here I have discussed two processes, which are plasmogamy and karyogamy. What is plasmogamy? It is the fusion of the protoplast of the hyphae of two opposite strains. And what is karyogamy? It is the fusion of nuclei of the two opposite strains of the hyphae of zygomycetes. After plasmogamy, the two hyphae of opposite strains undergo karyogamy, and as a result of plasmogamy and karyogamy, a diploid zygote is produced. Thank you, students.